Hey guys, what's up? It's Alex or Nuznuz here, and in today's video, this is going to be all about bank organization. I actually had a Discord mod suggest this video, so shout out to SkyShards for the suggestion. In this video, we will be focusing on three core ideas of organizing your bank, and that is going to be cleaning, filtering, and organization. First, I'm going to tell you how to clean your bank the easiest and get rid of all that junk that may be cluttering up your bank. To do this, we are going to be making use of filters to make our lives easier and really get everything unneeded out of your bank. Then we'll finally move on to making our tabs that will fit our playstyle correctly. And then we will finally be organizing these tabs so everything is perfectly in place. First, we are going to start off with the first steps to clean a bank, and that is clearing out all your junk. All right, so firstly, we are going to start off with how to clean the junk from your bank. Almost everyone's bank, especially if you're watching this video, probably has a lot of junk, ranging from untradeables to just items you threw in there and forgot about. I know my bank has tons and tons of unnecessary junk. So what we're going to be doing is first clearing out anything that you notice right away to be junk and just getting rid of it. So just take a quick glance through your bank and get rid of the most obvious pieces of junk you see. Now after this, we are going to start using the trusty bank filters and narrowing things down a bit. So first we are going to be using the clean up filter. So at the bottom of your bank, you'll see filters and you'll want to click the clean up filter. What this will do is show a bunch of reclaimable items in your bank that you can easily just left click to get rid of, and then you can go back to Django whenever you want and reclaim these items. I do this with almost everything, unless it's something that I'm going to use often, which for me is something like the Adrenaline Urn and the Spring Cleaner. Of course, some items are going to cost you some GP to reclaim, and don't worry, it will give you a warning before you get rid of an item if that's the case. Luckily, there's not a ton of items that will cost GP to reclaim, and if they do, you can either pay it when you need to reclaim it, or just keep them in your bank to avoid having to pay the fee. Now that we've used the cleanup filter, it should have gotten rid of a lot of items in your bank. After this, we're going to move on to the placeholders filter. What this does is it will show you all your placeholders. My bank tends to be cluttered with old placeholders that I once had that I totally just forgot about and never removed. For this, just get rid of every single placeholder that doesn't get used in your bank. This is a great way to clear space rather than having to manually go through your bank and look for all your placeholders. The final thing I'll note is the costume room, which can be accessed from the bank. You can build things in your house like cape racks, armor cases, and wardrobes to hold certain items. Once you have these built, you can deposit and withdraw things into them from your bank interface. So you'll click the small little house icon on your bank with the items you want to deposit directly in your inventory. Then you can deposit them into these wardrobes in your house to save a ton of space. Then whenever you need an item from them, you can take them directly from your bank the same way you deposited them. This is great for things like skill capes that you don't use too often and other sort of niche items, and it will really save you a ton of space. Alright, so now we're going to be looking at tabs and different bank layouts and how you make tabs. So once you have all your junk out of your bank, this is what you'll want to do. It's different for everyone. So to make a tab, all you need to do is drag an item onto a tab. Then you can right click the tab and select customize. Here you can change the name of the tab and also choose the picture you want to show up as well. If you don't choose a picture, you can always just have the item you dragged be your symbol for the tab. The tabs that I personally like to use for my bank is I have one big tab for skilling items. Since I'm already maxed, I don't skill a ton, so my skilling tab can easily be condensed into all skills. But if you skill a lot, you could separate these by type of skill like gathering, artisan, etc. Of course, we need our obvious gear and equipment tab. I also like to have a tab with all my clue scrolls just because I like them easily accessible. I have a potion tab as well with all my topped up potions, food, and summoning pouches. And the reason I do this is because it's super easy to see what potions I need to buy, and when I go PVMing, all my full dose potions, familiars, and food is all there. But since I have a potion tab like this, the thing I like to do is to make an odd dose potion tab that I almost never look at. So this usually goes at the end of my bank, and I don't usually organize it since it's almost never gone to. This is where all my odd dose potions will be. The only time I come to this tab is to take out all my potions and then decant them. A lot of people like to have their potion tab mixed with their odd dose potion tab, which is perfectly fine, but this is just how I like to do it. After this, the only other tab I have is a loot tab where I like to put all my loot. Lastly, my main tab, which is the infinity symbol at the top of the bank, is used to store general items like charms, spirit gems, random tokens, D&D things, journals, all the stuff that I don't use all the time, but still have a use that I don't want to get rid of. And that is how I have my bank tabs laid out. Alright, so finally, after you have all your junk cleared and all your tabs made, now you'll just need to organize the items. I usually start by going through working on one tab at a time. For instance, I'll withdraw all my potions and then deposit them into my potion tab and then move them around the way I want. This can be made easier for things such as gear by using the worn equipment filter. It can make it really easy to get everything into one tab quickly. Once you have all your tabs filled, you'll want to decide on how to organize them and sort them. For things like gear, I like to organize by style and put basically my main setups for each style, and then I'll have all my jewelry, capes, and niche use items all together. For something like skilling, I just organize my items by how they group together. So like all my protein equipment would go together, etc. This makes it really aesthetically pleasing and groups all similar items together. Lastly, I just wanted to mention another way to save bank space. Certain bags like the totem bag, clue scroll bag, key ring for your keys, skill cape shard bag, and statue collection bag for your mysterious rocks are all good items that can be used to condense items together and save you a ton of bank space. Your bank is all about personal preference, so make sure that you do what you feel is the best for you and your playstyle. If you like having a skilling tab for each category of skill like gathering, an artisan, and stuff like that, then you should do that. If you want a combat tab for each style of equipment, like a combat tab for magic, range, and melee, then you should do that. Your bank is your space and should be designed how you like it. But honestly, a bank that's clear of junk and that's nicely laid out is always a plus. It'll really make your experience with the game so much better. I don't know about you, but I just enjoy playing RuneScape so much more when my bank is nicely organized and clean. I hope this video helped you all out in your quest for a cleaner bank. If it did, please leave a like below, as it honestly helps a ton to get my videos out there. Make sure to subscribe if you want more RuneScape content, and don't forget to leave a comment below if you have any other video suggestions. As always, thank you to all my channel members for the support. You can click the join button below to join my channel memberships and get a lot of cool perks like joining my Discord, me adding you on Discord, PVMing with me, even merch sent to you and stuff like that. A lot of cool stuff, so you can click the join button below to check that out. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video.